You probably want to go a little bit deeper. This is your subcuticular.
I think you go to a place to train at any stage, and frankly to teach and do research and take care of patients also because of the people that are there.
Faculty are incredible. They're famous. I had Carol Greeter as a small group. You know, she's a small group leader in my first year and won the Nobel Prize. I mean, and then the next week was back, you know, teaching the small group.
I absolutely love our class. I think the class of Med 13 is amazing. We kind of went through GTS together, and I think at the end of the day, it's our classmates that they're the ones who really inspire us.
They are Peace Corps volunteers. They have prized fellowships that they've participated in. They are extremely bright, and we all feel like we probably wouldn't hold a candle to them if we were trying to apply at this time.
If you're fortunate enough to get in here and come here, you are going to see the best, and they're going to expect you, you know, to live up to that name, but you're given the best opportunities, the best faculty.
If you're an applicant to a Johns Hopkins program and you want to say, okay, fine, it's a great place to train, I hear the environment is wonderful and people are supportive and everybody is great when you're there, but how do people really do? Take a look at what people are doing when they're out of here. I mean, they are becoming leaders in medicine and biomedical science all over the world.
I do solemnly swear, by that which I hold most sacred, that I will be fully committed to Moses.
Changing a medical curriculum is really a big deal. It's like turning a gigantic oil tanker. It really is hard. There's so many people involved. We're fortunate enough to attract a very top-notch medical student. So they're excellent when they walk in the door. So it's not good enough to say that when they leave they're excellent, because they were excellent when they came in. We have to show that what we've given them is something that will allow them to take advantage of their talents, their enormous talents, and improve medicine over the next four generations.